Early game tempo, the natural tower pressure from the Chin and Enchantress. Now you couple it with the Wraith King, a hero that kind of sets up the rotations naturally. He's just going to be hitting creeps all game.
It's going to be a fast game.
Yeah, that's what I mean. And I think Sven might be a little too slow even if he goes for the Midas build on it too.
At least they didn't go with the super hard carry.
Yeah, I like this build. Pick it.
And we get some lonely offlaners.
Yeah, this is weird. This is sort of going back to the old days when you had 2v2 mid, basically. Oh, trying to break the salve, and they do manage to get it. So salve broken as soon as they pull it back out.
That is nice. That's an empty ball. So he needs this top rune.
Oh, sleep comes out. They have the splitter afterwards. In fact, mid one might just be going down here. They try and find the kill, and in fact, can they get it? The avalanche barely able to save it. The talk back under tower to try and turn the fight, but there's already creeps there. And now pulling back in that spirit power. Crit able to get it.
Oh,
this Wraith King, who's kind of continued to farm up so far, 40 and 18 on him.
Oh, did they just get all four stacks? One, two. Oh, they got three.
Look out down bottom as well.
Oh,
S4
kills are cool too.
Trying to get away from this one as the Fissure's going to land, and they will be able to run down at the Centaur, it looks like. So Nisha picking up a kill on top of having
attention there while trying to keep these towers up as long as they can, because you don't want to lose control of this jungle. It is a big moneymaker for them.
Oh, and Zai chasing down Fly now, going to give him the clap and then head away afterwards. So a little tip given over to Zai. Yaps are appreciating what his offlaner is doing.
They're trying to smoke up behind them, though.
This would be big if they could find it. RTZ looking for the opening, does spot out Puppy. Sumail is there as well. They're bringing in Zai and Yapzor, trying to get up close and personal. And well, PPD talked about this as the Ench killer. Can it work out here?
See, there's his tome. Okay, so he's got it now.
This would be a perfect kill. This is absolutely perfect if they can get him. Mid
question
one
is, how do you lead it? You've only got one point in the shackle, so don't miss.
Oh, he does miss. And the stomp, able to connect. They have the split earth afterwards, and now just running forward for him. But that fissure, able to keep him alive with the hand of God, the avalanche. It's not enough. Secret jungle, Anisha keeping his farm up as well. Only about 800 gold away from that relic, getting closer to the Radiance.
Yeah, Sumail's TP was on cooldown, so he couldn't stay bottom and try and get a trade.
Toss back. Bar under tower. They have everything for him. Control coming out, and he gets the stampede off. Able to run away. Finds the hoof stomp afterwards. Trying to take down two. X4 lamps. The Echo Slam doesn't do anything. And RTZ jumps in. Finds the catch for the kill. Oh, man. Secret beta boo-boo as mid one also going to get ran down here. Can they find the stun and the kill? They will.
Crit. No.
Yeah, and they're just going to back out.
How many courses we had? Just three. So they've adopted another one.
They could go on Denisha here. Avalanche, mid one, trying to find it. They don't go for the split earth as of yet. They find it afterwards. Mid one, very low. The stomp coming from S4 finds it onto them. The sleep afterwards. Nisha's in trouble. He's going down. And the fissure's actually blocking them off from getting closer. This is Nisha possibly going down. Hand of God, mechanism, everything to save my Wraith King. But it is not enough. And now Secret getting ran at continuously by evil geniuses trying to take down Zai. And they are possibly going to get it for him. Yes. Fly gets away.
That courser.
No. They manage to find him at the very end. Zai gets one more hit.
The golems. If he goes in for this Bloodstone build, S4 going to run into Puppy. Starts the initiation. Maybe taking a look here, see if there's any friends.
Oh, the root. It's keeping RTZ under fire, but he has his Blink Dagger. Going to come off cooldown in just a second. Should have it on him. Hasn't been delivered, actually, as of yet. They actually recall in Zai. So RTZ in some trouble now. He does not have friends with them, and Zai just continuing to run him down with mid one in the area. Can they get an S4 again with the stomp, and RTZ goes down. And now the stampede to try and run away.
Get himself that mana.
Now movement into the jungle. Yapzor gets the blink away up to the high ground. Power shot lands the stun. And they find Yapzor getting greedy up on top of the cliff.
He really did.
EG is like, we know that spot very well. You can't hide there from us. And they will find that pickoff.
Maybe it was a taunt, you know?
Possibly. Mid one in the bottom lane, they find him as well. And Crit chasing him down, has the shackle shot afterwards.
Really? He's now 0-6 and on just the boost travel function. The TP is always going to appreciate all that move speed in the engagements. Move speed from the smoke now for Secret.
Oh, they jump forward. They find him trying to get a turnaround here. Fly, able to get it. The splitter down. They have the shackle onto one. There's not a lot of damage coming out from Zai, but now he turns to try and find the fight for the hoof stomp onto three. S4 makes it happen again. They haven't been able to play Dota, but Yapzor coming in with the Echo Slam. It's not doing enough damage, though. Maybe the follow-up coming from Nisha with the Blade Mail is, though, as Sumail tries to run away. Yule Scepter, leave him alive. Is it going to be enough? He's still walking away. Crit controlling. Nobody has died except for that that Earthshaker, but S4 again finds the big stomp, the power shot afterwards. They need to run away. Zai's doing too much damage. The avalanche toss and the kill comes through.
Now, all of these creeps, they're super OP. Yeah, you get the stun coming through. Arteezy following it up, already initiating. Can they get enough damage out, though? It's looking like it's going to be there.
Zai also getting turned upon. They buy back on the Tiny, though. Can they get any more kills? Secret trying to find something afterwards. The Fissure timing from Yatsura's. The BKB wears off. Avalanche controlling up the Sven. He's able to get a good shackle, but it's not enough, as they will kill off the carry another time. Titan Spirit, they have the stomps to land on top of it.
Oh, but his spirit's going back.
They have an idea where he's at. Time to run away. And Yulsef built up Sumail. Actually going to find Yapzor. Maybe going to bring him down. Hand of God has have to be used. The power shot comes through to finish him off. And now mid one, able to control on to fly. I mean, Roche isn't going down quite that slowly. Can they really get there in time to contest without a buyback from Arteezy? It's getting super low fly, trying to make it happen, but it's not going to be enough. I mean,
oh, they're waiting.
that was a moment. And now looking for the follow-up. Another stomp, another catch, the Shackle! Able to interrupt at mid one, though, being that stalwart force in the middle of all of them to make sure they can't initiate onto the rest of his team does mean that mid one is likely going to die again, but he's able to keep the rest of them alive. Sumail still living through this one. Arteezy back in the midst of it, turns onto Zai, wants to kill him off instead, turns onto Nisha, barely able to keep Sumail alive. There's no mana on Zai! He gets one last hit for the shot, though. That's enough for the kill, and now Arteezy, trying to stand tall against absolutely everybody, needs to run away. The Earth Splitter comes through, still dodging, Crit even trying to slow them down with the Rin Run slow, but he will too eventually fall. And EG managed to get a couple of buybacks out.
Needs to find some more, though.
I like that. Zai, walking uphill. They have a Shackle shot lands. Nisha just gonna walk forward. They find the Hoof Stomp on the back line, but another
tiny,
Fissure. Mid one, not going to go down from that one. The Split Earth coming through as well as it lands onto Earthshaker. This is a nice one. All the Yapzor tries to drop the Echo Slam. It's not quite enough. Sumail needs the Yules to stay alive as he walks through the trees and it tiptoes way away. And Arteezy also having to escape. This Enchantress just does so much freaking damage. The Shackle BKB reaction from Nisha before it landed. Still trying to run away. Arteezy able to get it. Another round of Hoof Stomps coming through onto two, but there's no follow-up.
It's just delay. That's all it is, right? Every single one of these stuns, I feel like, is just trying to get them out. I still think this game is very hard for EG to win. It's going to take, again, just time and time for them to do it. Maybe they can. It certainly helps that mid one's been a virtual non-factor, but a damage sponge.
And this is a nice little pickup for them as well, taking down mid one. Can Secret get there in time? Not quite. Now they're kind of committed to this fight as well. Another great Fissure coming from Yapzor just to play spoiler to that kill potential. But Puppy, okay, they want the bigger kill. They want to find Zai. BKB popped the turn, trying to find that kill, and Zai is going to eat the dirt. Yapzor also, he stuck around a little bit too long. One by one, Secret going down. None of these heroes have buyback, Trent. And a stampede from time to time with that big stun that comes out.
Yeah.
But really not lacking that damage. That's where Crit is coming into play. And well, speaking of Crit, he's going to get pulled back in.
He's level 20, though.
Talent. And the chase forward, the Bloodthorn. Look at the damage coming out. S4 finds the stomp there again. On to 2 Arteezy, trying to take down one. It's going to be Zai. And now afterwards, turning towards mid one. The Avalanche trying to delay things, but it might. Oh, Yapzor! Where's the follow-up, though? Nietzsche's there. Do they have enough damage? It's not looking like it's quite going to be there as EG continue to run through them. And Sumail just backing away from Nisha. His BKB wearing off soon. And actually, Crit lives through this one as well. Avalanche isn't going to be enough. They actually reveal himself, and Crit goes down. Puppy also going to hit the deck. Another round of another bunch of kills. Nisha just trying desperately to hold on here, chasing down and finding Arteezy. They blow him up, able to get the kill on to Sven. Mid one with this buyback might be making enough space for the rest of his team.
Yeah, good buybacks there, and they know the Roche is up. We have to come back and fight for this one.
And S4 chasing. Sumail shows up for another round, and now catching on to mid one. This fight's gone on for forever, it feels like. Another Avalanche, but Crit doing the damage for his team with the Split Earth afterwards. They take down the Tiny.
They made it past, right? Sumail reading the game so well by going for that Shiva's guard. Yes. But EG, they have made it past. I was worried about the potential high ground there from Secret, but they held fast to those big pickoffs at the 30-minute mark. And now,
trying to delay. Wraith King jumps into the middle of him. The Aegis, it's going to get picked up, though. And now Nisha, he's committed. He does have ulti available, but does he end up having to pop it now? Crit trying to run away. Zai caught off to the side. They don't have BKB to pop. Untouchable doing so much work here. Sumail, can they get it in time? Still chasing. Sumail going to be able to find Puppy, but can he get any more afterwards? Nisha turning on Sumail. He eats the cheese and able to back away now. Crit still living through this. They're kiting it all beautifully. EG trying to run, try inside. The Echo Saber slow in the rundown. Nisha going to call. And they find themselves another round of another couple kills. Blade Mail be damned. EG, you're coming.
Last man standing. Falls dropped like an absolute rock on the Enchantress and the Tiny. And that big boulder was nothing but a pebble this game. One of them
crit nearby for Sumail, just in case he needs a save. He still doesn't have a BKB. Likely not going to see one this game, since he's very close to the Octarine.
Jumps in, finds the Absor. He's already used one round of it. The stun comes out. The silence is there.
Oh, he's in?
Easy, not caring about anything. High ground.
Couldn't even hit the buttons fast enough. He's like, I hit the mech, dude. I couldn't hit the hand of God for you. I'm sorry.
Chase forward now. Arteezy, he's feeling it, ready to go up on the high ground. It's a lot of damage out with that break. The avalanche toss. Arteezy pops the BKB, now trying to chase. This guy's mad, wants to turn him down, see if it's going to happen. And indeed, he finds one kill, now looking for the second, killing off his old captain, and now looking to take a bit more as the tier 3 tower goes down and everybody retreats. Chase forward though.
Once.
Avalanche throwing out that Wraith Fire Blast. Now Nisha, Shadow Blade, Chase, BKB. Wants to kill off Sumail, but Sumail very speedy on that ledge. Arteezy doesn't care. The rest of his team is dying. He's farming up a hard cam.
Give themselves a little bit more wiggle room here. Perhaps just one more item on some of these heroes. Another level. Anything that will help in this engagement, because they're certainly going to need it all. Nisha and Sumail tangling it out down here.
And Nisha?
Yeah, he's got the TP, but he's going to be careful.
Going down the TP!
There's a talent it there, my friend.
Ladies and gentlemen, Nisha getting caught out, killed. And that man just bought out. He doesn't have buyback.
This guy.
Sumail still holding on for the moment. They use the glyph.
Remember, when Nisha's dead, it's a 60k net worth lead.
That's just true. He is a
all right. That guy's got a lot of it tied up in himself.
And they do a buyback on Zai, but mid one jumping in. Yapzor able to find the Echo Slam. It's not enough damage. Arteezy able to get the BKB off. Takes down Yapzor. No buyback from him either. EG smelling blood. Going for the chase. Sumail still trying to run away. The Stomp is going to connect onto one, but their eyes on the prize. Evil Genius is going to take down these tier 4 towers. And Secret, they can't believe it, as they are not willing to give up. But this game is well and truly over. Evil Geniuses are going to go up 1-0 over Secret. And a disconnect coming out. Secret really struggling in that last couple of minutes, it felt like.
Yeah, EG, they stood the test of time versus that Secret lineup. To get themselves over the hump of that early game. Nisha was looking terrifying. Got himself that Radiance at a decent moment there, but his allies, they weren't quite on that same level with them, right? Mid one had a very rough start. Only a single death, I believe, for Zion in the first 15 minutes, so pretty good start on the Enchantress, but not enough for the whole squad to bring it together and go high ground there, and an absolutely unbelievable game from Crit and Sumail.